The Department of Transportation pushing for an electric ferry system that will serve the Manila Bay, Pasig River, Laguna Lake route. The DOTR is working with the Public-Private Partnership Center to develop the new mass transit system. It will be known as the Mapalia Ferry System Project. Transportation Undersecretary Timothy John Batan said it will be patterned after the Caypraya River Ferry System in Bangkok and New York City's ferry system. The agency, however, did not specify a timeline for the start and completion of the proposed project. President Marcos continues to go around the country to lead the distribution of government aid to farmers and fisherfolk. This morning, the chief executive was in Baler, Aurora. Rafael Bosano joins us with the latest. Raf, go ahead.
Hi, Denise. Following the devastation of millions worth of agricultural products and livelihood of farmers and fisherfolk due to the strong El Nino the past couple of months, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. led another distribution of financial and other forms of aid to affected agricultural workers and their families in Baler, Aurora, earlier today. Among the distributed aid is the Social Welfare Department's 10,000 pesos for 10,000 beneficiaries under the ACA program. Farming and fishing equipment, food, as well as fertilizer discount vouchers and fuel assistance. The Office of the President also gave out 10 million pesos to 1,000 beneficiaries affected by the climate crisis. He announced that an animal quarantine facility worth 10 million pesos will also be given to the local government and another 25 million that can be loaned by fishermen and farmers. At the sidelines of the distribution, Agriculture Secretary Kiko Laurel said that the DA continues to work hard towards ensuring food security, which is always put at risk in times of calamities and natural disasters. Now, these include investments in silos and drying systems for rice, corn, and even sugar. He noted that since taking over the department's helm, a steady decline in the prices of some commodities have already been observed, including sugar, fish, eggs, and chicken. But he admits that there is still a challenge on lowering prices of pork and rice. Now, following the drought in many parts of the country, which even resulted in some municipalities and provinces to declare a state of calamity, Marcos says the government is now preparing for excessive rains during the wet season. Aside from 180 million pesos worth of relief supplies pre-positioned in central Luzon, he highlighted the importance of the accomplished Aguang River Flood Control Structure Project in Baler, which will help prevent severe flooding and damage. Now, latest data from the DA shows that the El Nino has damaged more than 170,000 hectares of agricultural land and affected over 180,000 farmers and fisherfolk throughout the country. Despite this, the total figure of affected all compared to 1997 El Nino, where were impacted by the climate phenomenon. Denise.
Rafael Bosano with that story. Thanks, Raf. A Cebu Pacific plane slightly swerves off the taxiway at Naia Friday morning. The Manila International Airport Authority said there were no passengers or crew on board when the incident happened. But Cebu Pacific said the incident caused ramp congestion, resulting in some flight delays. As of this afternoon, the aircraft has been removed and was being towed to Cebu Pacific's building. After 4 straight weeks of fuel price hikes, motorists could get some relief next week. The Energy Department estimates gasoline could go down by as much as 90 centavos per liter, while diesel and kerosene could see a downward adjustment of between 1 peso and 1.15 per liter. The department cites softer demand from China and the recovery in U.S. oil production. The Philippines reports higher rice inventory in June. The Statistics Bureau says stocks of the staple grain climbed 19% year-on-year to 2.16 million metric tons. It was also slightly up from the 2 million metric tons in May. Monthly increases were seen from the National Food Authority and the commercial sector. But the Statistics Bureau notes rice inventory from households were down 19%. As for corn, stocks decreased on a year-on-year basis to 750,000 metric tons. On a monthly basis, though, this was higher by 5.6%. No factors were given for the higher or lower inventory of the two key grains.